Welcome to Hiitfootball. Today's session is going to be 30 minutes long. You need a football, any size will do. I've got a size 5 here, but you can use smaller. You need 4 cones, preferably 4 different colour cones. Now, if you haven't got cones, you can use any item around the house. Bottles, a piece of clothing, shoes, as long as you've got 4 and they're the same and different colour. And of course, grab a drink of water. It's going to be a really intense session. So, what we're going to do is just have a space around you, about 3 meters by 3 meters. You can have this in your garage, in your living room, outside, or in a park. So, let's get started. Now, Hiitfootball is all about intensity, using football as best you can to get as many touches on the football as you can through the session. So, we're going to be doing that throughout. So, let's get started. Let's do a warm up. We'll start down at the bottom. We'll just roll our ankles around and around so we're always in a dynamic movement. We'll do the right ankle, the left ankle, a couple of circles around, and then we'll just do a bit of knee action, like we're kicking a football. And then we'll do the left one. And then we're just going to swing side to side, just to get that side nice and going. You can put the arms up if you want. We're just trying to go side to side. And then we're just going to do our arms and our shoulders. So if you can do big round circles with your arms. And then maybe 3 all the way around. See if you can touch your ears with your inside of your biceps. Then we'll go the other way around. Can you do forward motions? Nice and high. Like a big couple of circles around your ears. Let's do 3 more. A continuous circle. Excellent. And now just kiss your neck. Go around in circles again. Nice and slow. Good. All right, so feel a little bit more limber. So we're just gonna get a bit more warmed up. So let's just jog in on the spot. And just get the timer going, because this is when we're really gonna be starting. So we're just gonna be jogging on the spot. Nice and gentle, we're still warming up. And now we're just gonna go high knees at the front. So can you bring those knees as high as you can? You don't have to go fast at this point, it's just warming up again. We'll keep them nice and high. Try and stay in one spot if you can. And then we'll do heels. So this is bringing your heels up to their bum, like this. Again, nice and slow if you want, just warming up. Keep your body straight, looking up at all times. Good. Now we'll just do some shuffling. So keep nice and low to your right, to your left. And you really just want to get nice and low. Maybe when you come down to one leg, you go a bit lower. You're really pulling on those muscles in the legs. Again, you don't have to go very fast. Bring that knee up a bit more as you go down. Side, side, side. Keep nice and low. Good. Okay, that's our warm up done. So what we want to do now is you get your 4 coloured cones or your 4 coloured items from your house. You want to place them roughly 2 or 3 metres in a square. So quite easy to do. You can put one down here. Just do a couple of steps. 1, 2, 3, one here, and you just go around in a nice evenish square. 1, 2, 3, and this is the area that we're going to be working in today. So grab your football. It's all about the football. Hiitfootball is we're going to go through the movements nice and slow, build up to a lot of pace, and then we'll do some real high intensity workouts. So first of all, we're going to do the shoulder down. So in a shoulder down movement in a football game, it's really good doing a feint and potentially going the other way. So shoulder down is there, and then two are coming, and then come back again. So just leave your football in the middle, but we're just going to go to your front two cones. So you go shoulder down to the left, run to the right, come backwards. Shoulder to the down on the right, and then to the left. So just get the movements right, shoulder down to the left, run to the right, back to the middle. Shoulder down to the right, and then run to the left. So just get that technique nice and going. Speed it up if you can. Obviously it's just without a football at the moment. And you just want to keep that movement nice and flowy all the way to the end. So that's going to be our movement we're going to do. Now, the second movement we're going to do is toe tap the ball. So can you look to toe tap the ball like this? Nice and slow. You can walk the pace. Make sure the football is staying in one place. If you're working in a garage environment like this where there's concrete, the ball will seem to move around a little bit more than if you're on the grass outside. Okay? So that is our second movement today. And our third movement is dribbling. So the reason why we've got four different color cones is because you're going to change the colors every time. So with dribbling, you want to dribble the orange cone, dribble back to the middle. Dribble to the white cone, dribble back to the middle. Dribble to the yellow cone, dribble back to the middle. And dribble back to the blue cone, dribble back to the middle. Now you may have different colours to me, that doesn't matter, as long as you're going to different colours all the time. So that's the three movements. So let's just go through them all in one. So shoulder down to the cone and back. Shoulder down to the opposite cone. Let's do that with the football now. So shoulder down, dribble with the ball, come back to the middle. Shoulder down on the right, go to the left, come in the middle. Toe taps, in the middle, toe taps. And then dribbling, we're dribbling to a cone, we're dribbling to a different cone, back to the middle. Now you can mix up the cones, it doesn't matter which one you go to, as long as you go to all four different colour cones. That is our three movements, shoulder down, toe tap, and dribbling, okay? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a minute on each, okay? Have a rest after 3 minutes, and then we're gonna do it all in one movement. Okay, so we're gonna do this for 1 minute on just shoulder down with the ball. Okay, so make sure you're ready with your ball. 3, 2, 1. Shoulder down, dribble to the other. Get to the middle. Shoulder down to the right, sprint to the left. Go to the back in the middle. Shoulder down to the left, go to the right to cone. And we're doing this for 1 minute. Can you do it in a nice, quick movement? Think about a defender in front of you that you want to get round. And you're going to mix it up. You don't want to let him know or her know which way you're going to go. Can you know it's going quick? So down to the left, to the right. Shoulder down to the right, sprint to the left. So you're always mixing up. The opposite side, you're feinting and going the other way. Potentially you can use different parts of your foot. Going back to the middle at all times. Left to the right. Right to the left. So keep going. 5 seconds to go. And stop, 1 minute is up. Okay, now we're gonna go straight in to toe taps, let's go. In the middle, toe tapping away. You wanna keep your eyes, if you can, high. But if you can't, that's okay to begin with. What we're doing here is we're looking for quality first before we look at speed. You always wanna try and keep on the balls of your toes, the balls of your feet, I mean, and you're just looking at touching that ball. If you can look forward, that's absolutely awesome. That is where we want to try and get to. But if you can't, it's absolutely fine. We're looking at just touching that ball every time. We're going to do this for a minute. Ten seconds to go. Speed it up if you can for the last 10. And time. Well done. Okay, get yourself ready again. We're about to go straight into dribbling to the four different colours of the cones. And go. So making sure you always come in the middle. You're changing the cones around each time. You're not going to the same colour two times in a row. And you want to try and be nice and quick. Can you use different parts of your foot to get there the quickest? It doesn't mean you need to go in a straight line. You can zigzag around, but as long as you're looking around. Now, what we're going to try and get to is looking up. Eventually, but a small space, it's a nice little short movement. So keep going. Remember to always bring the ball into the middle of the square, and you want to be going in each corner as best you can. Try and hit the ball around the cone if you can, with the little turns, back heels, moving around, but the ball keeps moving. And time. Well done. So that was 3 minutes of workout. Now what we're going to do now is we're going to do another 3 minutes, but it's going to be continuous. It's going to be shoulder down to a right cone, shoulder down to a left cone with the ball. After 1 minute, it's straight into toe tapping, and after 1 more minute, it's dribbling to the four corners. Okay, so it's going to be 3 minutes in total, and we're just going to keep going on a rolling basis. So make sure you're in the middle of the square with your ball. Make sure you're ready. We're going 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Shoulder down to the opposite cone. Come back in the middle. Shoulder down to the left side. So you're always going opposite shoulder and do a nice easy movement. Nice quick and easy. You're looking to put off the potential opposition in front of you to go the opposite way. And if you put your shoulder down and go the same way, potentially you're going to get tackled. So you really want to be pushing it hard. Left to right. Right to left. Back to the middle again. Left to right, that's where you want to be. Right to the left. So every time, this is what you're doing, left to the right. Nice and quick, minute is almost up. As soon as you finish this, we're going to go into toe tapping with the ball. So keep the movements going, as fast as you can, to the middle. Okay, toe tapping, 1 minute's up. So with this one, just get the ball in your foot, straight on the ball. That's all we want to be doing, nice and quick. And then, after the toe tapping, we're going to be doing dribbling to a different colour cone every time. Keep it up, we've still got about 30 seconds of toe tapping to go. Really important, you keep control under your foot, keeping those knees high as you can, not too high, and then we'll be ready. So 20 more seconds and we're going straight into dribbling. We're doing well so far. Alright, we're almost into the last 10 seconds. So maybe let's speed it up or look forward or both. Can you do both? But keep control of the ball. 3, 2, 1, dribble. We're dribbling to the middle. Mix up the cones. Can you do it with different parts of your foot? Different kinds of movements. Bucket comes every time. And off to the next one. Now you're in a short space. So you're doing lots of turning, lots of thinking. Which colour have you been for or been to so far? Can you come back? Can you even incorporate some of the shoulders down? But we're trying to go to as many colours as we possibly can. That is what we're trying to do. Different colour every time. We'll probably come up to about 25 seconds to go. Can we get the ball in the middle every time? And there's mine. To the left one. Back to the middle. Keep going, ball guys. We're doing well. We've got about 10 seconds. And we're done for this. Back to the middle. Orange. Back to the end. And time. Awesome work. Grab a drink of water. We're about halfway through our session. So grab a drink. Let's get ready for the next exercise. So for this one, it's slightly different. What I want you to do is get one of your cones, preferably one of the front cones. So in my instance, I'm going to use the orange one, and I'm going to put it in the middle. And it's going to be sitting in the middle of my two back cones. The white one, we won't be using this for the session, but the orange one we will. So what you should look like is almost a triangle. It should be a triangle. So you've brought one conal item into the middle of your area, and you're working in a backwards triangle now. So what we're going to do in this session is we're going to look at how do we change direction quickly. We're going to narrow it down so you've got to think on your feet, literally. So we're going to do some forwards ones around. So you can start on the left or right back conal object, and I just want you to walk forward, turn and come back. And then when you come back, I want you to go to the next cone next to you. So I'm going to go to my right cone here. We're dribbling. We're coming back to that one. And all the time, we're going to the middle to the right, the middle to the right. Or if you started on the left cone, middle, left, middle, left. So we'll do one more walk to that cone, come back to the starting point, then off to the right-hand side, back again. Now, can we speed it up? Can we jog? So let's just jog it, keeping the ball into the feet, potentially coming out to the right. Again, can that ball almost stick to your feet quickly? Can your eyes look up at all times? It's almost having a level on your head. Don't let the level go down. You want to be feeling the ball with your feet only and looking to where you're going to be jogging to. Okay, so we can do that nice and quick. This is going to be a short burst session. Okay, we're going to do a couple of these. So let's do our first session. Now, what I want you to do is also count how many cones do you dribble to. So if I dribble to the first one, that's one. Back here, two, three, four, five, and so on. So every time you hit a cone, you count a number. We'll do a quick burst, 1 minute. How quickly can you jog with the ball coming back in those three triangles? Okay, so have your ball ready. We're going to go in a minute and make sure you count how many cones you go to. So three, two, one, let's go. One, two, three, four, five. Okay, you guys can count your own. Can you do as many as you can in 1 minute? Keeping that ball nice and tight. We're looking for different turns. You're looking at almost the ball touching the cone every time. You can go different kinds of ways, back and forward, as long as that ball is pretty much moving in time. Keep counting. You want to be going nice and quick. Short burst of a minute. Make sure you always have that starting coming back. 10 seconds to go. Can you get quite a few more in? Pressure's on to get a few more. Woo. Time! Done. Alright. So take a breath. And what I want you to do, so remember that number in your head. Okay, so remember that number in your head. So if you've got 30, that is what you want to beat in this section. If you've got 50, that's what you want to beat. You want to go quicker than your session before. Now there's no cheating involved, otherwise you're cheating yourself. It's all about the quality on the ball, getting warmed up, and getting that touches as many times as you can. So, you ready? We're going to go again in 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Counting again. Can you go a little bit quicker than the last time? You might have your own technique going. Keeping football on your feet as best you can. All you'll be doing is keeping going, keeping that ball moving, different turns. You might want to use the base of your foot to backheel it back. You might want to go around quite turn. You might want to turn your body. You're going quick, you've got to beat that number. Let's focus a little bit more. Keep those cones going. Keep going. 15 seconds. Can you get your number? Can you beat your number? How many more times can you beat your number? Are you close? 5 seconds. And time. Woo, right on. Okay. So, as we roll through this type of exercise, we're gonna start doing a little bit more turnaround. So at the moment, we're just going to a cone and coming back, which is absolutely fine. This time, the cone that you brought in the middle, my one's the orange one, which formed the triangle, and it's in the middle of our original session, is the cone you want to go around. You're going to go around the cone. So how are we going to do that? Let's just say you've got your starting spot of blue in my instance. You're going to come round. You can go left or right of it, it doesn't matter. And you're dribbling around the cone, back to your blue one. When you hit your blue one, you dribble over to your yellow cone and you start there again. You want to dribble around the orange one. So what we're trying to find is you're always dribbling around the orange one. You're getting to the corner cones. You're switching the angle of attack. And again, you're going around. Now you can start going left or right around the cone. That's okay. So just give it a go. Just walk it if you want. Or start jogging to get used to going around. Now the trick is to get as close to that middle cone object as you can. We've been building up to this moment to try and go quick around, back to your blue cone or your yellow cone. So just do a couple more exercise runs, a couple more warm-ups on that one, just to get the feel of it. Now again, you're on a very short space. It's almost 2 meters, 2 meters, 2 meters. So control with the ball is very important. If the ball goes somewhere else, bring it back, try not to use your hands, have it as your feet, come back to where you started from. So let's do a minute and let's go quite fast because we're going to do the same thing. We're going to mix it up and get harder and harder on intensity. All right, have your ball ready on one of the side cones. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and let's go. So dribble around to the side cone, dribble down to the next side cone. Then you want to go around the middle one again in the middle, back to where you started from, dribble to the edge. And you're repeating that all the way through. Now we're not counting, you don't need to count at this point. We're just going quick to get it nice and sharp. Get used to going around that cone, the turning, around we go. Looking good, to the side cone, back to the side again. So you're always looking to go around that middle object. Keep the speed up, really important. The ball is still moving as before. All the way around. So we're doing good. 10 seconds. Back to the side, to the right. Can you get another one in? And time. Great work, everyone. So it's not easy when you're in a confined space, but if you think about it in a football game, you get closed down quickly in certain areas of the pitch by one, two, or sometimes three defenders. If you can sprint out of the traps and get around, shoulder and through, give you a nice, good advantage to get out of those tricky situations. Okay, so what are we gonna do now to finish off the last kind of 8-9 minutes of the session is we'll bring the middle cone back out so you've got a perfect square or the best square as you can get it. You're looking at about a 3 by 3 meter one. So what we're gonna do in most of our sessions, we're gonna also practice juggling or keep yuppies or keep the ball up depending on what country you're in. So to juggle, what you do is you're making sure that you're in this confined space of 3 meters by 3 meters. If it goes out, you've got to start again. And what you're trying to do is you're trying to keep the ball in the air for as many touches as you can without it touching the floor. And normally you count how many touches you can get until it touches the floor. So for example, for me, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, got 8 or 9 there, depends on who is asking. So what you're trying to do is you keep it out. If you can't juggle, if you haven't juggled before, you've just started out, what you can do is you can start by picking up the ball, just bouncing it, getting it nice and ready, and then when you want to, you use bounce, kick, catch. Bounce, kick, catch. Okay, so if you are a beginner or you're trying to learn how to juggle, that is the best way to start. That. And eventually when you get good enough, you can bounce it and go 1, 2, catch. And eventually you go 1, 1, 2, 3, catch. And then eventually you won't have to throw it down. Now in future sessions, we'll look at how you flip the ball up on the ground. So let's just practice some juggling. We'll practice for 2 minutes and it's all in your own sphere. So start now. Again, you can bounce it. If you want to learn how to flick the ball up, you can flick it up in a few ways. You can do it with your toe. You can do it with your side. You can even jump with the ball in your feet. You have the ball in the middle like that and start. So we'll go through our future sessions on how to juggle properly. But let's just do it for 2 minutes. Can you juggle and keep it in the confined space? Can you use both feet as possible? You want to keep it nice and close to your body if possible. Now, you don't need to always use your feet. You could use your knees like this, potentially. But you always want to be keeping the space. Again, I go back to the beginners. If you're just starting out, just get used to the ball being bounced from your hands. And eventually just stick your foot out. So you bounce, kick, catch. Bounce, kick, catch. And eventually you could do 2 kicks. And it's all about practice. You're not going to get it right first time. So what you want to be doing is you just want to be practicing, bring that ball. Now normally the ball is spinning backwards all the time. That's what you want to be done. Let's see how many you can do. Okay, so we'll do another 40 seconds. Can you stay in your space, keeping it nice and low? Again, bounce and kick if you're just starting. There's absolutely no problem with that. What we want to try and get to as well is, can you look to use both feet? So left to the right. Can you do a combo? Right, left, right, left, right, left, right. Lots of ways you can juggle. So 10 more seconds. Just getting used to the ball. Nice little break in between sessions. Well done. All right, let's stop it there. So we've got just shy of 5 minutes to go. We're going to look at a skill move. Always look at a skill move at the end of our session. Today's skill move is the Cruyff turn. Johan Cruyff back in the 70s pulled off this move in a World Cup game. Since it's back to become a very popular move throughout the world. What a Cruyff turn is normally you're going at pace, but let's just do it as walking. You go at a walking pace. And one of your foot, normally your dominant foot, in my case my right foot, comes over the ball like a semi kind of circle. And from the inside of my foot, right here, I'm going to go bring the ball around, bring my foot around and behind me. Then I'm going to turn on my planted foot and then dribble the opposite way I've just come from. So I'm going to walk that again. As you dribble, you stop the ball if you want, you bring around your foot, your leg, twist your foot, bring it behind you, and go the other way. So let's try that for 1 minute, and you do it at your own pace. Let's go. So bring the ball in the middle, can you bring your foot around, and then back to where you come from. And start again. Can you go in the middle, bring your leg, bring your foot around, and go back to where you come from. Now, if you're a bit more advanced on this, you can do a Cruyff turn in the middle, a Cruyff turn where you've just come from. If you're constantly Cruyff turning, what you could also do is you can go to different cones. So you could jog in the middle, Cruyff turn, maybe drip to the yellow one. Cruyff turn to the middle, Cruyff turn to the blue, so on. But if you're just practicing, just go from one angle in. So go in the middle, jog in or walk in, stop the ball if you want, leg round, twist your foot, inside of the foot, touch the ball, and jog back quickly. start again. So let's just keep practicing that move. What you could do also, you could try on the other foot. Stop the ball, your left foot come round and then back again. So this is about learning a skill, mastering the skill. You don't have to go fast, but it's understanding this skill is available in your movements in a game. And this could be a game inside or outside. 5 more seconds, in the middle, Cruyff turn back, and done. Very well done. So what we've learned today is we've looked at a warm-ups piece, which you could do before games, potentially after games as well. We've looked how could you feint or shoulder down to go to the opposite way. How do you look to dribble around your head up like a level to different movements and different angles and different cones or objects. We've looked at how to go in a straight line and then around the cone to come back again. We've done some juggling, and then we finished with our skill move of the week, which today is the Cruyff turn. So you're welcome to play these videos back recorded, master sessions, contact us if you've got any questions, and we'll be back next time for the next video. Thank you for your attendance, thank you for your patience, and also I hope you've learned something today at Hiitfootball. I'm Alastair McLae, see you next time. Thank you.